This video provides an overview of catalog items in the service catalog, what they are, and how to create them and define variables for them. Users order goods and services from the service catalog via catalog items. For example, a new laptop or software installation or office furniture. Catalog items may contain variables that a user must specify in order to fulfill the request. For example, in order to install software, we need to know the type of computer the user has or its operating system. Or the item may have optional features that the user can select, like this interesting office chair. Catalog items are grouped into categories and subcategories to help users find what they're looking for. Categories also ensure that the appropriate teams are assigned to fulfill orders. For example, all IT-related items could be assigned to the IT team. You can create your own catalog items or modify the sample data items provided in the base system. To access all of the catalog items in the service catalog, navigate to Service Catalog, Catalog Definitions, Catalog Items. We can also use the shortcut to the Service Catalog administrative functions from the link on the System Administration homepage. Let's add a new catalog item for the cool office chair we saw earlier and define variables for the chair's special features. We enter the item name, being as specific as possible, then leave Active selected to make the item available immediately. Next, we can specify whether the catalog item is available in the service catalog when the user views it from a desktop computer, or mobile device, or both. For our example, we want the item to be available to desktop and mobile users. Now we select the category, which organizes items and allows users to search for them. Note that if an appropriate category doesn't exist, you can create a new one, which we cover in the Categories video of this series. In our example, we select Furniture, a category previously added to our Express instance. Next, we need to select the execution plan, which outlines the tasks required to fulfill a request for this item. You need to set up custom execution plans for fulfilling requests. We cover creating a new execution plan in the execution plan video of this series. Next, we enter the price of this item and select the currency. Remember that the price of items can trigger approval rules. In this example, a price over a certain amount requires approval by a member of the procurement team. Approval rules are covered later in this video series. Back in our catalog item form, we can edit user roles to make items available only to users with certain roles. In our example, all users can order the item, so we leave this field blank. Now we want to provide more details about the item, including a picture of the item that we upload and an icon which will appear when the item is in a list. And finally, we provide a short description and a detailed description of the item. In the mobile section, you can specify the mobile picture type, either the same image used for the desktop, a different picture for mobile, or none. You can also choose to hide the price from mobile users. In our example, we'll leave these options as is. Now we save the catalog item, and we use Try It to preview the item as it'll appear in the service catalog. Looks good, but how do we add the optional recline and massage features to the catalog item page? That's where variables come in. After saving the catalog item, a variables list appears where we can create new variables. We want two checkboxes, one for each feature. So for the type, we select checkbox. We enter the text that we want to appear next to the checkbox in the question field. We can also enter a price in the price if checked field that will add the price to the total cost of the item if the option is selected. In our example, the optional reclining feature is $50. We can set a default value for the variable as well. We do not want the value selected, so we set the default value to false. Order determines the order in which the variables appear on the page. In the order field, we enter an order value of 100, as we want this option to appear first on the list, and we'll set a higher number, such as 200, for the next option. Now, when we save the variable and preview the item using Try It, we can see the new recliner variable option on the page. We repeat the same steps to create the massager option. And now we have both variables defined for the catalog item. Here's the new catalog item as seen by a user. When we select the optional features, the price changes accordingly. For more information, please consult our product documentation, videos, or blogs, or ask a question in the ServiceNow Express forums.